right? And what are its advantages? So today you can see that Arduino board. Okay, just go see the board, because they will ask the diagram of the Arduino board, right? So please just go through the Arduino board, right? So I told about the different analog digital pins, right? So you just see the Arduino board, what all that it contains. Okay, so as I told that your Arduino board is this is the Arduino Uno learning board, I can say, right? You have power pins. Okay, so just see the diagram. This is very important layout. Sometimes they will ask you to write UNO. Remember the word UNO, the Arduino learning board. Okay, now so microcontroller is Arduino brain. Everything Arduino board is meant to support this microcontroller. See here, there is a microcontroller. So that is a, you see the here, the in the next slide. So number one, so this is a number one, right? And that is a power reset button. Okay, that is a reset button. And number two, okay, number two, sorry, number two is AREF, that is a analog re-reference. So AREF stands for the analog reference, and it is used to set an external reference voltage. Okay, so your digital pins contains 1 to 15. Okay, so labeled as 0 to, so that can act as a input. See there, okay, one is a reset button, two is a analog reference button, and three is a ground pin. There are a few ground pins on the Arduino, and they all work the same. And fourth, 0 to 13 can be used for digital input or output. Fourth slot, you can see here, 0 to 13, right? 0 to 13 is for the digital input, that can act as inputs or they can act as an output. And number 5 is the pins marked with the tilde mark can simulate the analog input. That is a power width modulation. Yesterday I told, no, PWD means, right? So that is power fifth pin. And sixth, you can see the USB connections, that is used for powering up your Arduino and uploading. Number six, see here. Okay, fifth is the PWD analog output. Okay, it will show the arrow. Okay, next, sixth is the USB connection used for powering up your Arduino and uploading the sketches. Okay, next, number 7, receiver and transmitter, TX/RX. Okay, transmit and receive the data indication LEDs. See the 7 here. Okay, you can see the letters also, TX and RX, transmit and receive the data. So number 8 is the T-Mega microcontroller. We call this microcontroller as the brain of your Arduino board, right? And everything on the Arduino board is meant to support the this microcontroller. So the ATmega3328P is the name. Okay, see there, number 8. So it is the microcontroller. Okay, it is called as the brain of your Arduino board, and all the pins, whatever is mounted, all are supporting this microcontroller functioning. Okay, so next is number 9. See there, the number 9 is the power LED indicator. This LED lights up any time the board is plugged in a power source. So that is the 19 is the LED. That is whenever you are going to supply the power. Okay, whenever you are going to power source is there, then this LED will glow, right? So that is the 9th. So when you come to the 10th, voltage regulator. This controls the amount of voltage going into the Arduino board. So because you know that, so voltage fluctuations will be there, right? So we are going to use the regulators everywhere. Say for example, in our house, home appliances also, we are going to use the voltage regulators, right? For television set, okay, for fridge, okay, because the whatever the mesh electronic circuits you have, when if you don't have the voltage regulator or the voltage controller, then due to the fluctuations of the power high and low, you may get that electronic circuit ICs may get burnt. Okay, that is why continuous supply of power and the controlling of the fluctuations of the voltage, we use a voltage regulator where there will be a stagnant power supply, continuous power supply with the equal number of volts, right? So that's why even Arduino board is also a made up of electronic circuit, right? So we want to supply the power supply without the fluctuations. That's why we are going to use a voltage regulator. That is a pin number 10. Then pin number 11. So DC power barrel jog. This is used to powering your Arduino with a power supply. See here. 11. So this is a, it is something like a, the, it is going to supply the power to, I think you people are familiar in our CPU also. We have SMPS. That is a switch mode power supply, right? So some, that is also receive the AC voltage and it is going to convert it into the DC voltage, right? So like that, even the Arduino board is also will have the voltage regulator, and pin number 11 is a power supply jar, right? Where the Arduino board, the power is going to be, this is used to power your Arduino with the power supply. Okay, and pin number 12 is 3.3 volt pin. This pin supplies 3.3 volts of power to your projects. Okay, so 12, pin number 12 is the pin which is going to supply the 3.3 volts to power your projects. Then pin number 13, so pin number 13, see there, that is used for the supply of 5 volts to power your projects. So pin number 12 is 3.3, pin number 5 is the supply of 5 volts. Then pin number 14 is ground pins. There are a few ground pins on the Arduino, and they all work the same. Okay, see here, ground pins 14, pin number 14, it is a ground pin, so it is going to work on they all work the same. Next, pin number 15, these pin can read the signal from an analog sensor and convert it into digital. So they called as a analog pins because they they convert analog sensor and convert it into the digital signal from analog sensor and convert to digital. See here, pin number 50. So you just memorize the circuit layout of the IoT Arduino, sorry, Arduino board. IoT physical devices and Arduino board is one of the device which we are using. Okay. So I told now these Arduino board, when set as inputs, these pins can read voltage. They cannot read two different states, high and the low. When set as an output, these pin can apply voltage and they can apply 5 volts as we call it as the I, and the 0 is referred as a low voltage. Okay. So this power jack is where you connect a component to power up your Arduino board, right? Normally it is recommended for 5 voltage, right? 5 volts. There are several ways to power up your Arduino: rechargeable batteries, disposable batteries, wall warts and solar panels also we can use it. Okay. When the reset button is pressed, the program that is currently being run in your Arduino will start from the beginning. You also have to reset a pin next to the power pins and acts as a reset button. When you apply a small voltage to that pin, it will reset the Arduino. Got it? Reset button. What is the function of the reset button? Okay. So what it does, the when you press the button, the program that is currently being run in your Arduino will start from the beginning. Okay. And you also have a reset pin next to the power pins that act as a reset button when you are going to supply the low voltage. So here you can see analog pins, that is a pin number 15, A0 to A5. Okay. So these pins are labeled from A0 to A5 and are most often used to read analog sensors. They can read different amounts of voltage between 0 to 5 volts. Additionally, they can also be used to digital or input output pins like the digital pins. They can also used as a, because as I told that they will convert your analog sensor into the digital. Okay. So that is what about the layout of your Arduino UNO. They will ask, draw and label the skeleton or the Arduino UNO board, right? So if you 1 to 15 are there, in that you have, these are the different pins which I explained. Okay. Just remember, you have the microcontroller with pin number 8, which it is a AT328. MEG328P, right? So we are using, this is the latest Arduino board which we are implementing. Okay. And low voltage means it is 0 volts and high voltage means 5 volts. There are two pins, 12 and 13. They are going to supply 3.3 and 5 volts respectively to power your projects. Okay. So that is about all the layout of your Arduino UNO AT-Mega328P. Okay, remember that number is very, very important, because yesterday class I told some of the different old Arduino's board, like MKR 1000, right? And